Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Ummatul Muslimin. Insha'Allah, for today's synopsis, we'll be looking at the last half of the 13th juz of the Quran and the first three quarters of the 14th juz of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in this portion of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about a very important verse, and that is with regards to showing gratitude for what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِن كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. That you show your gratitude for what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase us in that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase us in blessing. وَلَإِن كَفَرْتُمْ. But however, if we are ungrateful, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's punishment is indeed severe. This shows us a very important aspect, that whenever we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we generally ask for what we do not have. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us that if a person wants something to increase, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if a person wants Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase them in barakah, in blessing, they should show more gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for He will increase them in that affair. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this portion of the Quran too speaks about a conversation, a dialogue between the devil himself and those that are destined to hell. And as we know, that when things go wrong in this worldly life, generally we always blame the devil. And we say, this is the devil's work. This is indeed the devil's work. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, when those that are destined to hell are condemned to hell, they will all turn to the devil, to shaitan, and they will all begin blaming shaitan. But shaitan would say, فَلَا تَلُومُونِي وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. That do not blame me, but rather blame yourself. Why? He would say that all I did was call you. All I did was invite you, and you obliged. In other words, in the end, we have no one to blame but ourselves. Shaitan cannot force us to do something that is wrong. Shaitan, Iblis, the devil, cannot force us to do something that is incorrect. By doing something that is incorrect, that is solely our decision to do so and to disobey the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us guidance, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us away from the whispers of shaitan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Hijj, this is the beginning of the 14th juz, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of a very profound verse. And this is, إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. With regards to the Qur'an itself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that it is us that has revealed this book. We have revealed this Qur'an. And indeed, we will protect it. And subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it goes without saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has protected His book through the million different huffaz of the Qur'an around the world today, alive today in the world. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, during this period of time, it's about approximately 1,440 years since, revelation. We can say 40 to 50 years, 1,440 to 50 years of revelation. Subhanallah, not a dot in the Quran has been changed. Not a letter of the Quran has been changed. You know, in this period of time, certain languages become extinct. You know, certain civilizations become extinct. You know, rivers that were flowing in a certain direction actually change direction during this period of time. 1,440 to 50 years. And subhanallah, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is exactly the same as it's been revealed. The language that we speak today, English, 1,000 years ago, if someone had to speak to us, we wouldn't have understood anything. But subhanallah, you look at the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, exactly as how it was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that's how it's revealed today. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the next surah speaks about His blessings. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the different animals that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us to consume. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the milk that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, that it flows bayna damin wa farthin, and bayna farthin wa damin, that in between dirt and blood, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extracts pure milk for us to drink. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the honey that how the birds Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had instructed them to take its house, to erect its house upon a high place, and it should go around extracting the nectar from the different flowers and the different plants that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created. And through that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us pure honey. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention with regards to this, fihi shifa'un linnas. In it is a cure for diseases for mankind. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's blessing. And there is no way more beautiful to put it than the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said it in the Quran. وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If we have to try and count the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we would never finish them and we would never be able to count them. فَتَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنُ الْخَالِقِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the end of this portion makes mention of what Ibn Mas'ud mentions as one of the most profound or comprehensive verses of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ. And this is the basis, the foundation. You know, if somebody asks us, describe Islam. What is Islam? What does Islam teach? Why are you people so different from other people? What are the values of Islam? And subhanallah, a person can simply just recite this verse. You know, this verse, Ibn Mas'ud mentions, the most profound, one of the most profound verses of the Quran. To us, it gives a different meaning. When we hear this verse, we know it's time to get up. The khutbah is over and it's time to perform salah. But it had a different understanding and a different feel when it came to the Sahaba Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ. In Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed instructs towards justice and good. وَإِيْتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى. And being good and righteous to your fellow men and your kingsmen. وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ وَالْبَغْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbids against profanity, indecency. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibits you from evil. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibits you from oppression. يَعِذُكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving you this injunction so that you can be from amongst the mindful. So these are the core values of Islam. Number one, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ. Justice, to do good, and to forbid against profanity, to forbid against evil and injustice. These are the core values of Islam. With that, I conclude. Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.